Hi, this is Dr. Harry Anderson. Today we have the privilege of being here with Faith Dugdale. Faith, how old are you?
I'm 13 years old.
13 years old.
Yes.
I think you've done quite a few things in your young life, haven't you? I have a magazine here with your picture on it showing you and two of your horses with the Fort Worth downtown as a background. How did that come to be?
I show with the APHA, the APHA Paint Horse Association, and they were looking for their next new cover for the Youth World Show series.
Okay.
And they wanted they liked the backdrop for Fort Worth, and they wanted to find somebody that lived in the area.
Okay. And you had a couple of pretty good looking horses here too, didn't you?
Thank you. It was really exciting. I was really glad I got to be in it.
Okay. So you're going to be showing in the youth world here soon?
I will be next year.
Okay.
They have a youth show in the summer, okay, and they have an amateur show in the fall.
Okay. And one of the things you're noted for is singing the national anthem horseback. How did you come to do that?
You know, I just started singing when I was real young. And as I got older and I started performing more, my mom told me a lot how just people from the old days, and Reba, I know Reba used to sing the national anthem at a lot of rodeos, and we just decided to do it on my horse.
Okay.
And tried it out.
And it became popular.
It did.
Now you're in demand.
Yes.
Yes.
Especially for the paint horse. They love it when I can come out on one of mine.
And Faith, you have a couple of interesting stories to tell. And tell me how you came to get started, or why you started feeding Total Equine.
It started out a lot because of colicking from our horses, and we heard that how it really helped with that. And Jared Ruddy, who we get our feed from, told us about his stories and how his horse hadn't colicked in 2 years after colicking at least twice a year.
Mm-hmm.
So we decided to try, and it really worked for our horse because one of our other horses used to colic in the spring and the fall and has not colicked since, and it's been a full year now.
Okay, so you've gone through two seasons when they normally might colic, and you've been without colic free.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you feel it's fairly safe from that standpoint.
Yes, I do.
What about some of the other effects you've seen with Total Equine in the muscling and the hair coat? Have you seen a change kind of in their coloring and their hair coat?
I've seen a lot of change in their coloring and the hair coat, and especially in the excitement and being real frisky. They tend to be a little bit calmer and not as amped up, which I like a little bit better, and it's
okay.
I think it's a lot better for them. Just
so it helps. You feel it helps their mind be a little more stable?
I think it does.
And a little more friendly. They're always friendly though, aren't they?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. And you also have a story to tell about your horse here. What's his name?
Jackson.
Jackson. Jackson had a little accident. Tell us about the accident.
He did. Back in the beginning of March, he had been out in a pasture eating some grass. It was cooler that day and a little bit rainy, so I guess he felt excited, and he hadn't been exercised in a few days or so. And he decided, I guess, to run around. We weren't there when it happened, but he ran around, and we came to find him about 45 minutes just after checking on him. And we had found him just standing out there by himself with his injuries.
Okay, and how did the injury take place? I have a picture here that shows the extent, and probably can't see this very clear, but this gash is about how long?
It was at least 3 inches long.
Okay, fairly long and is wide open.
Mm-hmm.
And according to your mom, I'm looking at this picture here and I can see the jugular vein in the neck area. It was that open and it tore the flesh open.
It did. It went all the way through his muscle and came very close to hitting the jugular, but it didn't.
Okay. And it also, at the same time, the same thing went into just below his eye.
It did.
And tore a hole in the cheek right below the eye. And that
it
looks
did.
Pretty bad, doesn't it?
It went right through his nasal cavity and went all the way through. Luckily, it didn't hurt his vision or anything.
Right.
We think he was running around in the pasture. We found what it happened on. It was on the chain link fence that was there. And we are guessing that it maybe went in through his face first, and then it came out. We don't know how it happened, but apparently it had gotten both. It came in through his face first, went all the way through, and he had gotten his face out, but then was still, I guess he was still sliding, and it got his neck or the other way around.
Okay.
But it got one or the other first.
Okay. And I see the injury spot here.
This is the one on his face.
Yeah. And all you can tell is some white hair, right?
Just a little bit, yes.
Just a little bit. There's really no scar
or
anything else.
Not too bad, no.
It healed
Completely did very shut. Nice. And she, this was the injury that the vet was more worried about because of the nasal cavity and the infection that might get in there.
Sure. And what about, can you show us where that scar is?
The scar, it cut about from here to here, and that's how long the scar is. And it's been in here, and it kind of ended in his muscle just a little, but it's not real noticeable unless he hit it with the sun.
Yeah.
But right from there to there is where it got him.
So it's hardly visible anymore.
Hardly.
When did this happen? How many months ago did this happen?
It's been about 4 months at least since it happened.
And how long did it take it to heal and come back to where it looks like today?
It took at least 2.5 to 3 months.
Okay. But that's quite amazing that he could heal from an injury that severe that quickly.
Yes, everybody was real surprised with it.
And it didn't bother his disposition? He hasn't gotten spooky over it?
No, he hasn't gotten spooky. That's what we were worried about, how his attitude would change. I know a lot of horses come out of bad accidents and get real scared from that point on. But he hasn't had any problems, and I've had the same easy training, just getting him back in shape and getting him ready for the next show season.
And Faith, at your young age, you've done something that not a lot of young people do. You've trained a couple of horses, I hear.
I have. I had a little bit of help with this one, just getting the saddle on and getting on his back for the first time.
Yeah.
But as soon as we knew he was safe enough, I trained him from that point on. I taught him just his groundwork and all of his basic, the lead changing,
okay.
And just picking up the correct lead, stopping and backing, manners, and a lot of the groundwork and the showmanship.
Okay, great. And the other horse, how'd that go?
The other one I broke completely on my own. He was easy. I never had any problems with him. Just started out with complete groundwork and then finally got on him, and he was fine with everything. Taught him a lot of what he knows, and we just recently put him with the trainer because of a big futurity he has coming up.
So they're pretty smart horses, aren't they?
They are.
Yeah.
I was very pleased with both of them and surprised with myself for being able to do it.
well, there's a certain talent there that not everybody can have that you can deal with a green horse, because they were green when you started, right?
Yes, they were completely green, especially the other one. It was challenging. He knew his basics just from the people who had him. He could walk on a lead rope. He could get in the trailer. Mm-hmm. I just taught him complete saddle manners and ground manners.
Good. How about the hooves on your horse? How often do you have those shoes replaced?
This one, we took his shoes off after the accident because we knew it was going to take a lot of healing, and we just decided to let him go barefoot.
Oh, he's running bare. Okay, and how often do you have to trim those?
At least 6 weeks.
Okay.
Every 6 weeks.
And are they pretty good quality hoof walls?
They are. They've said it's been really nice, haven't had any problems. No cracking, just probably minor breakage from getting long or chipping off, but nothing major.
But the trimmer feels they're very healthy.
Yes.
Okay, that's good. Well, Faith, I appreciate your time. And I appreciate the opportunity to visit about this today. And good luck in all your endeavors. And I know you're going to do extremely well.
All right, thank you for having me.
This is Dr. Harry Anderson. If you'd like more information about this or any other topic in the equine field, feel free to visit my website, totalequine.info.